Why do you think Americans, and I know you visited the United States, I want to talk some about that, are so fascinated with royalty, especially British royalty?
I don't know. It's very hard to say. I do remember as a very young child, when I was about 12, that my father and mother paid a state visit to your country. And I remember they were telling me, and I got it from a lot of sources, the excitement that was in the United States because they traveled through the whole country. When they met them, there is this phenomenon that you describe. It's very, very nice to see it. I don't know why it's there. Probably you would know better. But they did go throughout the whole country, and they even ended up in Hollywood. And I remember as a small boy, the film came out, which was called White Christmas. And
sure do. Bing Crosby, Danny Kaye,
Rosemary Clooney.
That's right.
And I remember at the end of the film, on the stage, as the film ends, you can see my father and my mother, and that was a special clip that they had done in the studio for them. And we as children thought that was very exciting.
You visited the United States as a prince. I understand you met President Eisenhower. You got a speeding ticket, and the president knew about that. What's that story?
Well, the president of the United States, Eisenhower, was a very close personal friend of my father. And my father called me one day into his office and he said, pack your bags and go to the United States. And I said, what am I going to do there? I was about just 18. And he said, you're going to be a guest of Eisenhower and you're going to travel throughout the whole of the country and see all the industrial and military complexes. You're going to go to all the universities and see them and spend the next year doing just that. And I was extremely lucky because I had to grow up very quickly. I was not allowed to take anybody from my homeland with me. I had never written a speech by myself before. I had never given a press conference before. In fact, I've never cashed a check or bought an airline ticket before. And so when I arrived in the United States, I had to do all that, and you grow up very quickly then. And one day I was driving a car with a cousin of mine, and we skidded across a red light. And we collided with another car, which a lady was driving. Thank goodness no harm was done to her, but I had smashed the lamp on the left side, and she said, let's exchange papers. And we did, and then the police turned up. I told them who I was, but they wouldn't believe me. So I was locked in with my cousin in jail until the sergeant on duty released us. When I went to say goodbye to the president of the White House, the most influential man next to him was a gentleman by the name of Haggerty.
Jim Haggerty.
I came there with the Greek ambassador, he was the press secretary, and they both told me that I had only 20 minutes with the president as a courtesy protocol visit and in and out. And I said, fine, but I have a message from my father, the king, on the negotiations between Greece and Turkey on Cyprus. And they said, I'm afraid you can't give any messages. This is a courtesy call and you're out. So I sat there, and the president was very kind to me, and I sat with the ambassador and Mr. Haggerty. We talked about my visit. And then slowly, slowly, he had this very gentle way of talking to young people, and he gave me courage. And I turned around to him and I said, you know, sir, I have a message from my father, the king. You do? He said, looked at Haggerty and the Greek ambassador, said, you both can leave the room right now. And I stayed alone with him, gave him the message, which took 30 seconds. And he kept me there for about 40 minutes, talking to me about the war, about the leaders he had met. You know, I never opened my mouth, I just listened. And when I left the Oval Office, at the door, he called me back. And he said, young man, come here. And I came back and I said, yes, Mr. President. He said, what's this I hear about you going to jail? I said, Mr. President, I had no idea that he knew about that. And he said, I don't mind you being picked up by the police in my country. What I want to know is, are you going to tell your dad or am I? So I said, no, I think I better tell him.